very shortly, those names will be stepping out onto a stage in front of Buckingham Palace to a worldwide audience.
Yes, welcome to our one show, Diamond Jubilee Special.
Once again, welcome to our One Show Diamond Jubilee Backstage Party!
But you know what? You can't have a party, can you, without some great food. So we've invited our favourite chef, Heston Blumenthal, to make a restaurant. Now, Heston, keep it simple. We only need cucumber sandwiches.
And look who's over here as well, the military wiser chef. Tell you what, girls, you've done a fantastic job with the bunting and lovely decoration on
and
the bus.
And you look gorgeous. Also, we've got Sir Elton John, Kylie Minogue and Stevie Wonder. They'll all be dropping in to say it to someone.
Yes, and it's all happening aboard our fabulous one-show bus. And let me tell you, we have got the best driver.
We're all going on a summer holiday. No more worries for a week or two. Fun and laughter on a summer holiday. No more worries for me or you. For a week or two.
Or at least 4 days for the Jubilee weekend.
Oh, and Swickliffe is not the only guest on board. He did a brilliant job,
then. Indeed he did. Now, by royal appointment, it's this evening's ringmaster, Gary Barlow, and our first night of the night, Sir Paul McCartney! There we go!
First of all, we must say it's a bit sad. We've just heard the news that the Duke of Edinburgh has been taken to hospital. Yeah. But the palace have decided to go ahead with the evening. Yeah. You know, whatever.
Imagine
if
you heard that news,
Gary.
Yes.
Such a shame.
It is a sad. Really sad.
I think it may have just been a bit much for maybe yesterday, you know, with the flotilla and all of that. Being
yeah, I couldn't have done that.
Yeah, I know. It's remarkable.
I was caught watching it on telly.
Yeah, it was a rotten day, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, Her Majesty, she stood, didn't she, for the whole time in just a suit. She must have been freezing, but she did a great job.
Well, we wish him all the best.
Yes, you know, we do wish him all the best.
And here we are, Gary, a few months ago, we were in the palace ourselves talking about this whole thing. It's finally here.
I know, I can't believe it. I know, it's incredible, and it's massive as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it was funny, it was 2 years ago we started to plan this concert, and the crazy idea came up within about an hour or so of let's have the stage over there instead of in the back garden.
Yeah.
When I got here on Thursday night and saw the stage set up, I couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
I think it also shows, because I saw Sir Paul's band on stage the other night. Now, these guys have played all over the world. They're all taking pictures of one another. Even the bands are really excited about it.
But that's the thing, even backstage here, you know, you see folk artists seeing each other, haven't seen each other for ages, and there's a lovely feeling
it's
about
it. Exciting, yeah. You know why it's not in the back garden? Because last time we did it, I was in the lineup with Her Majesty, and I said, "We're doing this next year, will we? It'd be great." She said, "Not in my backyard, you know."
And how did the whole collaboration between you two start? How did you get involved? Is this something you wanted to go for straight away?
Gary came and saw me for this one, and I'd done something for him before.
Yeah.
And so we knew each other.
I must say, the meetings at your office are always fun. Because he does this thing where he goes, "What do you want me to sing?" Yeah. And you go, "Anything you want, what do you think?" And he goes, "What about Back in the USSR? What do you say to this?" And you come up with these songs, what do you say?
Yeah.
And he just asked me, you know, and we talked about what songs, and I refused to do everything he suggested.
Yeah.
And we just came up with it, and it was great. You know, I like the lad.
Well, are you both happy to stick around with us for a bit on the bus? We know you're very busy, but it'd be great if we could hang about for a couple of minutes more.
Yeah.
All right. Well, the man apparently is filling up.
Let's have a look at some pictures here. I mean, the streets are filling up as we
are. There you are.
Right. And these are people who aren't even kind of invited. They just turn up to look at this. You know,
they just walk up to see this, can't they?
Yeah. Wow. Now that's it. And these are scenes that are happening right across the country. And we think Lucy is just outside of Buckingham Palace, just a stone's throw away. Lucy, where are you?
I am just outside on the top of Constitution Hill. It is so exciting here. The atmosphere is really, really building. Now, what is happening now is that the 10,000 people who are lucky enough to have seats for tonight's epic concert are filing in and taking their seats. The atmosphere is incredible. Some of them are so keen. They camped out last night in that weather. Some of them have been here from the crack of dawn this morning. I also got here very early this morning, walked up Constitution Hill, and I heard Stevie Wonder and Sir Paul McCartney doing a sound check. Amazing. Tonight's concert is not to be missed. It's going to be epic.
Now, the pair of you both went woo and wow as soon as you saw that top shot.
It's quite a scene, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It's really great.
Is the idea there's going to be kind of images and all of that projected on that stage from the phone?
Yes, we get darkness at about 9:15, and at that point we start projecting onto the palace. There's even someone performing on the palace later.
The roof. Yeah.
I'm going to ask you that a bit later on.
Have you seen much of the Queen over the last few days? You know, obviously on the flotilla and the
statue.
I
ran into her at a do at the Royal Academy, and it's always amazing seeing the Queen, but in person, she just is so incredible.
Yeah.
And I was saying to someone, you know, when she took the throne, I was 10, so, you know, I was a kid, very impressionable, and I just loved her.
Yeah.
You know, this idea that we were going to have a woman as our monarch, it was very impressive for me. And then when you see the films that Charles has been showing, and you see them,
that's beautiful, wasn't it?
So humanizing.
Yeah, yeah.
You know,
well,
you see it with the kids,
and
I love seeing Charles. You go, he's giggling away.
Yeah.
I think it's great because people sometimes think the monarchy is just a bit distant, and you realise, you know, as I do as a 10-year-old kid, they're just good people, good example, I think.
And as a 10-year-old child, did you think you'd perform in at the Diamond Jubilee Concert?
No, can you imagine that? Yeah, I never thought I'd meet her. Certainly, never thought I'd be performing for her. She's great.
Well, it's not just at Buckingham Palace where excitement is building. People are gathering in the centre of Swansea too. Carrie, are you there and can you hear us? There are 20 towns and cities with these big screens transmitting the Queen's Jubilee Concert and also the One Show tonight. I've come down to Castle Square in Swansea where we are attempting something slightly different. We're going to see if we can break the record for the biggest royal Mexican wave. So we're practicing here. If you live within half an hour of Castle Square in Swansea, this is the place to be. Get yourself down here.
Screens all over the UK, all over the world. I mean, this has to be one of the biggest audiences that you've ever played.
You're starting to worry us now.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, you all seem very relaxed.
No pressure.
Actually, when does that moment come when you think, right, you know, I am kind of here to do a job. I've got to put on a good show.
For me, at soundcheck this morning, I think when I saw the stage, I hadn't seen the setup. And it's very impressive, you know, and you're standing there and you're looking down the mall, which was only half full. Because this bit was clear. But then you start thinking, oh, it's going to be full. Oh,
because we were speaking to Sir Clifford earlier on, and he even said, you know, I will start feeling nervous. Even though it's great seeing friends and, you know, catching up with people, the moment before you go on stage, you can't help get, you know, butterflies once again.
Expectation. 50 minutes and 50 seconds to go.
You're really worrying me.
Well, we want to know how you're preparing for the concert at home. So take a picture of yourself in front of the telly or wherever you are right now and send them to the usual address, theoneshow@bbc.co.uk.
And we will get some stuff. Whoever turns up, the show is a little bit later on. Now, the Queen has been touching the lives of people since the start of her reign. And Angelica Bell has been to meet some One Show viewers who told us about their special moments.
What do you think?
Exactly.
Is that right?
Just like a garden.
Don't drink all that tea at once.
Now, upstairs, Paul, you touched on your memories as a boy, you know, of the Queen. But you would have been about 10, wouldn't you, in 1953?
Yeah, exactly, 10, yeah.
What were your memories?
We know that you were exactly 10, because we've got some homework here.
Oh.
Of a young Paul McCartney, who is 10 years old and 10 months.
10 months.
There you go. It's a very important.
Very accurate,
10 months. Yeah. So what's the story behind this? Do you remember that?
There was a competition for all the schools, and you had to write about coronation or about monarchy. And that was my entry, and I won a prize for that.
Won a prize?
Yeah, I did. Lord Mayor of Liverpool gave me a book.
Still on display, though, isn't it? It's, I think, isn't it? It's actually in Liverpool.
Neat handwriting, I think.
Yeah.
10-year-old.
few little mistakes.
Yeah,
a few
mistakes.
You had to be
And Gary, you of course will never remember the coronation, but you were just about old enough, weren't you, to remember the Silver Jubilee
in 1977,
wasn't it?
Yeah.
I think we've got a little picture of you looking very cute as a young
yes.
boy. There you
oh,
are.
Oh, it was great. It was great. I remember the whole street all having a big garden like this.
Yeah.
That garden, it brought the whole neighbourhood together. As it's going to do today, you know, to see the whole of England waving flags. It's brilliant.
Last night on that documentary, you said a lovely thing where you said, I was up against the railings and I would never imagine that I would get on the other side.
Yeah.
Look at what you've done.
I know, it's been amazing.
Well, getting back to the concert tonight. Now, Paul, you didn't give us any hints whatsoever to what would be on your set list. Can you give us, you know, will there be a sing-along? Because you're closing the show, aren't you?
There's a little bit of a sing-along, yeah.
Right,
we don't have long, you know, nobody on the show has long. But there is a little bit of a sing-along, yeah. Can ask the audience to join in on one little bit.
Oh, yes.
Can there be some booms and bangs? Can't think what number that will be on. you know, we're going to have fun.
Yeah, I'm looking forward. I think I know what that sing-along might be, and I think it would go all the way around the UK as well. And it'll just keep going and going and going.
Okay.
Gary, what are you going to be doing? Is something the show?
Doing a duet. You've given that away.
I mean,
thanks very much, everybody. Anyway, there you go. And then we're coming back on after the duet, and we're going to do Sing, which is the Diamond Jubilee single.
Right. Okay.
So I'm really looking forward to that.
The girls must be so excited. And we've seen them already. They look glamorous.
And also, as well as the military wives and Gareth, we have about 30 people from around the Commonwealth who've came over to join us. The slum drummers are here. The African Children's Choir are here. And they're loving being in London. They can't believe all this.
Yeah. Okay. Brilliant.
Yeah. I love in the rain.
Yeah. And obviously, Paul, I mean, you've met royalty so many times, you know, it's just been wonderful for you to be here as
well. Yeah, I've been very lucky, you know, since the early days of the Beatles. I've met royalty quite a few times, and as you say, I never thought I'd meet them ever as a kid. But I think the main thing is for me, he said, sticking his phone in his pocket. main thing for me, you know, is the human aspect that you never realise, because we always see them on stamps or money or whatever, you know. The first time I ever met the Queen, well, I was in a lineup, and she lives at Windsor, obviously. She said, where are you playing tomorrow night? And I said, we're playing at Slough, Mum, which is just outside Windsor. And she said, oh, that's just near us. And it's just like, you wouldn't expect her to say that, you know, it's near us.
Yeah.
Oh, you mean Windsor, yeah? So I've always found her to be very warm and very nice. And, she came up and opened our performing arts school, which is my old grammar school in Liverpool,
Yeah.
And I talked to her the other night and she remembered it. I said, do you remember that? She's all there, you know.
And it's going to be a big month for you, Paul, isn't it? Because you've got this tonight, but later on in the month, you're celebrating a big birthday.
Yeah.
Any big plans for that?
Family.
Right.
Just kind of family. I like birthdays just with the family. I don't like to do a big thing, you know.
Are we allowed to say which birthday?
Yeah, 70.
70.
Big 70.
Really incredible.
You should just have a massive concert in your garden. Something like this. Set up a stage in front of the house and have a good set.
That's one way to go, yeah. I don't think I'll be going. I think I'll be going the small.
Well, listen, have a good one tonight. I'm sure you will.
Thank you very much.
Right, do you have a time check? Now, how long into the concert?
Well, I can't quite see because our camera's in the way.
It's 42 minutes, they tell us, until the concert starts. Now, the 10,000 lucky guests who got their invites through the ballot are making their way to the seats from the Royal Picnic on what is already, I'm sure, a day they will never, ever forget.
Yeah, Matt Allwright has been to make sure that they'll have a picture memory of this Diamond Jubilee.
It's the garden at Buckingham Palace. Come with me. All the marquees are set. The picnics are ready to be picked up. And the steel band is ready. All we need now is about 10,000 people. And the very least I can do is help to hand out the food and give people a little something to remember the day by.
Really nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So let's get you with Buckingham Palace in the background. Here we go. Ready? Somehow I've become the Jubilee official photographer for the one show. I'm going to take a picture of you on your lovely picnic blanket.
Never imagined that I'd ever be at Buckingham Palace.
And what's it like? What do you make of the place?
It's crazy.
It's unreal.
Chantal and Shireen from Sheppey. Hello, how do you do? Nice to meet you. I like the fact that you managed to get to the champagne tent so early. Not quite gobsmacked that. He looks like he's about to propose.
I've got a ring the same as Kate Middleton's. Mine is new though.
Smile.